He's one of the most successful recording artists of all time. Everybody's so excited. 15 number one hit singles, multi-million hit albums. Her latest album is called The Emancipation of Mimi, and she's here to sing one of her classic tracks. We're delighted to have her in the studio singing We Belong Together. It's Mariah Carey!
Weekend. We've read about five stories today all about you over the weekend. Mm-hmm. Is that right that you were caught, well, not caught, you were running around your hotel in just a dressing gown? Why?
No. Okay, here's what happened. Okay, exactly. Here's what happened. There was a fire alarm. I don't know why these things have to happen to me, but whatever. There's a fire alarm that went off at the hotel, and usually, you know, you'll think it's a false alarm or whatever, but it was really loud, and it kept going. So we were like, okay, is there a fire? And I'm like, can I get dressed? Because I was getting my hair and makeup done and in my little, basically nothing, little,
don't
whatever you want to call it. And so then I got here and I was like, I just got dressed quickly because I was like, if I have to run outside, I don't want to be, you know, that'll be the next story. She ran outside nude for no reason, you know?
It was a false alarm.
It was a false alarm that lasted like a half an hour.
Oh, God, so head splitting.
Were you around the cold? Where were you? In the car?
No, I was in the hotel, but I was just trying to figure out. And then the security kept calling me, being like, everything's cool. But sometimes I'm like, are they telling me that for real? Or just they don't want me to go outside and panic and whatever.
Now, on Saturday, we read again, you'll probably say, that's not quite the way it worked.
Right.
That you won an arm wrestling competition with a DJ, Joe Wiley.
Well, actually, she asked me to arm wrestle because she heard that I was strong or something, I guess. And so I was the arm wrestling champion of my junior high school.
Were you?
Until, like, eighth grade. I was. Until eighth grade when the guys started getting a little bit bigger. So then, you know, I had lost to one of the bigger guys. But, yeah, so we arm wrestled. And
but it said that the report...
I must make up one point here. I am the current arm wrestling champion of this desk.
Of course you are.
I am.
As well you should be.
You don't want to...
I would if I were in a better outfit that wouldn't, you know, lift up in the back, because then they'll say I stripped on the show or something. And it is morning TV, and, you know, I'm not used to daytime things. I'm not prepared.
Anyway, Joe apparently got... injured. I don't know if you
I
injured her.
I hope she
her.
Didn't get injured. No, what happened was I don't think she expected me to be strong, because she looked quite strong, and she was, you know. I'm not trying to say she wasn't strong, but I think people just aren't ready, because I was the champ.
She just wasn't prepared.
It was, what happened was, it was like an arm wrestle like this, and then her shoulder, I guess, something happened. Hopefully she's okay. She was very cool, and I enjoyed being on her show.
Yeah,
DJs will watch you with respect even more from now on. Let's go and get stuff.
Now, yesterday, you were on Oxford Street. You were supposed to arrive in a helicopter. What happened there? Because that was what all the reports were saying, that you were going to arrive in a helicopter, but you didn't.
I don't know where they got the helicopter thing from.
Does it drive you mad, all these stories that you're always having to bat off?
Well, when they said the helicopter thing, I was like, really? They said that? I was like, that'd be pretty cool. I would actually like that, because it'd be fun. You could, you know, it'd be very quite James Bond to come down and, you know, and like a little string come down and come in the helicopter and, you know,
well,
be fabulous.
I read it in Friday's paper, so I said to our producer, I said, Jane, get a camera crew over there. We'd like to show that on Monday. Because it was a taxi, and apparently... Oh, another thing, you apparently gave the taxi driver £150 tip, which is about $300. Is that right?
Well, I don't know the money, you know, situation. I'm not good with numbers.
No.
So, so that was the money that I had with me, because I had to arrange for my own transportation. And I was just like, okay, here's the money. I got to get to inside and see the
fans. That's fantastic. Now, we're pleased you're here, because right after this, almost immediately, you are heading for the airport.
Yes.
Going back to the Billboard Music Awards.
Yes.
For which I think you're nominated for everything.
It's a lot of nominations. I'm very thankful.
How many? A lot.
There's a lot, yeah. So it's a nice thing, and I couldn't miss it, and I really wanted to stay, but I was like, honey, gotta get to that show. Working too hard.
It'll be a great night. It'll be something to remember.
Nice to see you excited about it, because the amount of awards that you've probably received in your career, you know, you still got that excitement for it. It's important to keep that, I would imagine.
Well, it's really exciting, and especially because, you know, We Belong Together, the song that I just sang, has actually become... in America, the biggest radio song of all time. It's become the biggest song of my whole career. So, meaning that it's a whole technical thing, but it's the most plays a record has gotten in audience. So that means a huge deal to me, and I wrote it with my friend Jermaine Dupri, who's an incredible producer and just a great person. Yes, we love JD! He needs to come over here. He's very excited by that response. Yeah, so it'll be fun, and I need to be there with him tonight. You know,
And tell us about the album, The Emancipation
Tomorrow.
Of Mimi. Yes, the title, really unusual title. What does it actually refer to?
Well, Mimi is just a nickname that really only my family and close friends would use for me, but I have a million nicknames. Like, it could have been the Emancipation of whoever. I don't want to give any of my other ones away. Mirage was one in high school, but, you know, I'm not being... Mirage is from high school. Mimi kind of stuck with me. So I thought it'd be cool, because every album I've had has been like Daydream, Music Box, Butterfly, and people started taking shots like, what's her next album? Unicorn, you know? So I was like, let me just think of something. And it really is like very much... the music is very representative of who I am as, you know, a real person. I thought that Mimi kind of brought me closer to my fans, because as opposed to like the whole Mariah Carey thing, which is its own baggage and whatever. So I thought it was cute. Now my fans know my private nickname, and now I have to have a new one because my family is mad at me.
And it's a huge album, and there's so many tracks on it. How long does it take to produce an album of this size.
Because you co-produced the whole thing, didn't you? Mm-hmm. And wrote or co-wrote half the song, not all of them.
All of them, yeah.
God, wonderful.
Yeah, because I didn't do any covers. I've always written all my songs. And it's interesting, I was doing an interview last night with somebody for the LA Times, and he was saying, well, it's a long story, but he was just saying he feels like, you know, the reason I don't get credit as a songwriter is because people see this whole diva thing, and yeah. they'd rather talk about, like, red carpets and rose petals and dressing gowns than, like, oh, she was in the studio producing a song. How cool. You know what I mean? Because yeah. unless you're strumming a guitar or you have a piano in front of you, you're not a yeah. musician. I don't know.
And one of your prized possessions is Jackson P. Mutley.
Jackson, my dog.
He's
yes.
your dog. What does the P stand for, just out of interest?
For what he does in the corner.
Exactly. And he does do that quite often in the corner. Yes, and you know, we try to take him outside and whatever, but I think he prefers carpeting. I don't know.
Is that right that he's appeared on front covers with you? Not only that, he's got his own website?
He's got three websites.
A dog with three websites.
And I didn't initiate these websites, mind you. I love my dog like nobody else. I mean, forget it. I'm in love with this dog. And the fans actually, I guess they sensed that, and they made these websites. The first one was from Japan. It was called Love, Love, Jack, and I was like, that's so cool. And then there was the Marvelous Jack, and the new one is Doggy P. Fly. Because my fan club is called Honey Bee Fly, so they called it Doggy P. Fly. So I think he kind of senses it, you know, because he gets his picture taken
I think he knows he's special.
I think he does.
Because not many people or humans or anybody get the chance to take a bath with Mariah Carey, but he does. He leaps in, doesn't
He'll
he?
That's the thing. He loves water so much because when he was a pup, I put him in the pool, and like at first he was a little bit like he didn't know what to do, and then he was totally excited and kept jumping in the water. So anytime I'm like running a bath at home or whatever, I have to make sure the door is closed, or I'll get in the bathtub and he'll be swimming around in my bathtub. No, he's really obsessed. He's obsessed with water. Yeah.
Now on the web, I know you said your dog has three websites, but yes. you have an official website, of
yes.
course. And on it, there's a list of Mariah-isms, little uh-huh. words and phrases that you use. And I think we've got a list of them somewhere.
We've got some. There's Okie Dokie Smokey.
Okay.
Well, that's a standard, isn't that a classic? Or you guys don't have that one
well,
here?
Well, we have Okie Dokie.
Okie Dokie, but not the Smokey.
But that's everything's
oh,
okay.
Oh, Smokey. I think I got that from my mom.
Yeah.
I think when I was little, she was probably like Okie Dokie Smokey.
Oh, yeah. And what's Papow?
Oh, Pippity Pow.
Pow?
Pow.
But don't you sort of do a thing with that?
No, I just go pow.
Oh, pow.
And what does it
well,
mean?
It just means, okay, like your shirt is pow. I like your shirt. Earrings, very pow. You know, you just something that kind of like an excitement, you know.
You've got your own language. What is lammy? What is lammy?